Hello and welcome to the second part of our travel video. We will continue to visit some of the most interesting and scenic parts of the northwestern states of America.
But besides the numerous other interesting places, Yellowstone will be the main focus, and we are seeing it now for the third time. It is a place of natural wonders.
We'll start where we left off, at Crater Lake. First, we will visit Hell's Canyon. Then we go through Idaho to see Crater of the Moon. And we will end the film at the Yellowstone National Park, greeting Old Faithful. For the next 4 or 5 days, we will be driving through desert country, making various stopovers at places we want to see. Coming from Crater Lake, first comes the high desert. The landscape is pretty rugged and wild, very few cars on the road, even less people, and it's going up and down continuously. We did not expect so many mountains, but once we're over this pass now, then we should hit the low areas. The plan is to make camp in the middle of the desert. Can you imagine the forces that caused the split in the rock? The split in the rock is just wide enough for the road, and pretty soon we will make camp for the night.
Tomorrow we will go on a jet boat tour in Hell's Canyon.
This is the deepest canyon in North America and a mecca for river rafters and kayakers. The difference from top to bottom is about 8,000 feet or 2,400 meters.
I started getting big. Really, it's taking it all in. This is my 8th year driving for this company down here.
When the captain grips the handrail, it means hide your cameras and prepare to get wet. And we did, right to the bone.
We are getting into a rough area.
Over here. Over here is yours. That one's rocky. We'll get hurt. This is Granite Creek. Class 4 also.
Do you have to give us a specific? My bottom's
going to go. Sneak up on it. Maybe it won't be so bad, right? Alright, everybody ready for Granite?
This will be our first jet boat ride, and it is pretty exciting.
Okay, now I'm gonna swing the boat around. pretty good down through here, didn't it? Look at it, going down through the rush creek.
There was a fire earlier in the season. These people are waiting for our help.
The people in the raft were unlucky. They hit the rock and it started leaking. So they scrambled ashore and called for help. Our boat came along for the rescue. Their 5-day boat trip on the Snake River ended on the second day. Now and then the Snake River takes a bite and spills its venom into unsuspecting tourists.
It took an hour to get all the people and their stuff loaded on our boat, and now we carry them home. A section of calm waters, and we meet a lot of rafters going floating down the river.
First, left side take theirs first, and then turn the other direction.
All right, you're ready to swing to the right here.
Getting the rough, I always hit the camera in a plastic bag.
Our boat trip is ending, but we still have to drive to our campsite that is another hour's drive further south in the canyon. The next morning on our way out, we surprised a black bear family on the road. There was actually a mother with two cubs, but it happened so fast that we could not stop the car and get out and get some decent pictures. Another day of hot desert driving is ahead of us. Over 100 degrees Fahrenheit or 40 degrees centigrade. Desolate landscape, but still interesting, and it's about to become even more interesting. Craters of the Moon is a volcanic eruption site dating back about 15,000 years. According to the scientists, one can detect four layers of the most recent eruptions. It's an extraordinary place, and we want to spend 2.5 days exploring the area, doing a lot of hiking. Also, we are looking forward to a good night's sleep, because last night in Hell's Canyon we couldn't sleep at all. It was simply too hot. A brisk wind is welcome relief.
We have never seen such an unusual landscape.
With supper and the chores being done, we are too tired to wait for the setting of the sun. So we retire quickly for the night, because tomorrow we will explore the entire site, roughly 1,000 square miles. And here we are the next day, bright and early, walking and recording whatever is interesting on a volcanic eruption site. Time and erosion have broken down the bare lava rocks, and plants are springing up in between the cracks. A lot of minerals are visible on the surface. Algae and lichens grow all over the place. With a little bit of imagination, you can see strange form and figures. Here a Roman soldier, a gladiator. That's what I see. Anyway, they're pretty certain that the last eruption has happened about 2,000 years ago. Now you can see how fast or slow the world has changed since then. We are about to climb this 700-foot high basaltic lava rock. From the top we hope to have a beautiful overlook over the whole area, which is true as we can see right now. nice view of the crater and the surrounding area. Just a beautiful overlook, worth the climb.
Going down on the solidified lava rock.
On our second day, we carry on with our exploration of the lava fields the same way than the first day, but heading into different directions always.
It is time to retire for the evening.
This will be our last day here, and we reserved it for going spelunking in some of the numerous caves that are present here. We were warned to take flashlights with us so that we don't get lost too easily. On a bright sunny day, we'll go underground.
The entrance to our first cave. What a distinctive face. Those caves are mostly called lava tubes. They can run for hundreds of meters. Watch out, be careful. Oh no, too late.
Going down one hole, coming out of another one some 200-300 feet away. Well, this was certainly a different scenery, a different place, and we are leaving today, saying goodbye to Craters of the Moon, going east towards Yellowstone Park. Big black clouds foreshadow a coming storm, and our route leads straight into it. Lightning has struck and ignited a forest fire. Smoke billows up on one side, while on the other a beautiful rainbow develops.
The bad weather is behind us.
We have rejoined the Snake River. It's a lot calmer and greener here, being in the Jackson Hole area of the Grand Teton Mountains. This is still pure Western cowboy country, and we are out for a Chuck-wagon dinner. Let's find out what the old cowboys ate on a cattle drive.
Inside the big dining hall, cowboy decorations.
He just shaved his legs.
Back in the saddle again.
Beautiful entrance to Jackson Hole, all built out of elk horns, an indication that a large population of elks are living in the area. In order to digest last night's Chuck-wagon dinner, we're doing a bit of sightseeing and walking around in Jackson Hole, which is in Wyoming, a center of tourism, summer and winter.
The old Wild West is still very much alive here.
Inside of the visitor center is a beautiful wildlife museum, which we are going to look at. Nice fall colors, but also our first sight of fresh snow. A white surprise for Yellowstone Park. This is our greeting. But we drive on, convinced that near the hot geysers it will be a lot warmer.
So we are waiting what surprises Yellowstone has. Nice, much better, thank you.
And the sight of rising steam warms you up right away. Finally, we have arrived at the main event.
Well, he could punch it, but it takes forever for the
bus. Have you heard whether they opened the pass up or not?
They just did. Oh, done leaving?
Pass is open.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Sure.
The geysers are not the only attraction that brought us here. There's also the wildlife, the natural beauty and the scenery that is so spectacular. The next 4 days will be filled with sightseeing. We hear some noises in the back of us, turn around and see this geyser going off. It's not all faithful, but just as beautiful. We're being 300-400 feet away and observe it from the distance. Yellowstone Park is the world's largest volcanic geyser basin and is also at very high elevation, between 6,500 and 8,000 feet, so around 2,200 meters average. The geysers are spread out over a large area. The park itself is almost 3,500 square miles big, and it was established in 1872 as the first national park in the world. As you can see, comfortable boardwalks are provided for a safe viewing. All are wheelchair accessible. This geyser has been blowing off for quite a long time, but it seems to lose steam now.
This was a very nice demonstration.
The surprising things about the geysers is the variety. Sometimes the water is crystal clear, other times it's a dirty mud pool just bubbling. Here this little crater comes out right off Yellowstone Lake.
Algae and bacteria have adapted to the hot water, creating a colorful picture.
The first encounter of a lone buffalo, quite close to the hot pools. They are accustomed to the area and the people also, but we are still talking wild buffaloes. In this picture, the buffalo is about 15 feet away, so about 5 meters, and we are standing on the boardwalk. Going from one side to another, sightseeing is the whole job for us all day.
It is such an amazing landscape, it leaves us speechless. Hot water and steam is coming out of the ground, which is hard to imagine.
In a moment, we will go inside the lodge to find out when Old Faithful will be erupting.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Coming out of the lodge, we find another geyser erupting, but it's not all faithful, so we hurry to get a little bit closer. What a spectacular sight!
What amazing colors, and now clarity.
Now we are at Old Faithful, waiting for it to erupt. Beauty. This is Old Faithful. Thank you. Old Faithful is the only geyser that can be predicted on a regular schedule. All the others blow off whenever they feel like. Heading home to our campsite after a very eventful day. Opening the curtains next day, we stare in disbelief at the white snow. It is snowing. To make matters worse, the heater in the camper doesn't work. So we run the engine to get some heat.
I hope those campers have warm sleeping bags.
Coming down from the Continental Divide, which is about 2,500 meters high, the snowfall stopped and we see the first elks in the park. We are on our way to the next geyser basin. Keeping up with our normal schedule, and that should bring us to Mammoth Hot Springs today. But we always stop for wildlife. First, we will do the mid-geyser basin.
Steam is rising out of every crack in the earth.
Thank you.
This crow seems to be very interested in motorcycling and probably wants to hitch a ride with it. When we saw this herd of buffaloes grazing on the side of the road, we pulled over, stopped and taken those pictures. In the meantime, we have found out that several thousand of buffaloes are roaming free in the park. The number of elks should be even higher. Occasionally, wolves and bears can be seen, but there's lots of other wildlife around. The proper name for the buffaloes is actually wood bison. This guy is taking a picture of an osprey, a bird of prey. Wherever this bird hunts, there are lots of fish. The whole area is covered with a little bit of water that is so clear that it can hardly be seen, but it carries minerals that deposit on the ground, making it very colorful.
Here the water flow becomes visible.
And we plan to continue our tour tomorrow.
The first thing is we meet lots of buffaloes.
A bull like this one can weigh 2,500 to 3,000 pounds and will stop the traffic every time it crosses the road. However, we are quite lucky to see so much wildlife just off the road. This elk is trying to get rid of the velvet on his horns. A lookout with some interesting scenery.
Multicolored rocks.
This is Mammoth Hot Springs, where we will stay for another 2 days. The geyser formations are here quite different to all the other places, and I can hardly wait to get some pictures. Just take a load of this. You can't see it, but a thin layer of water is running all over it. An interesting question comes to mind. Can you picture this? Yeah, we can. Here the water and steam become visible. Most of the formations flow down in the form of a terrace, step by step, and they are changing continually over time.
It's a completely different picture than the geysers that shoot up into the air.
This place was active 10 years ago, but since then has dried up completely. The internal plumbing system is changing often dramatically. A leftover hollow tube.
Hot water is gently running downhill, forming those terraces. When you see this for the first time, you'll be pretty amazed about the creativity of nature.
pretty close, having completed our circle tour, coming back to the same area where we started. Right now we're just heading down the mountain, showing you some inactive places. The terrace formation clearly visible. And like I said, 10 years ago, hot steaming water would be running over these formations, producing those colorful pictures we see in the active geysers.
An eerie dead area, and coming up, a still alive one. Every time we come here, Yellowstone is just amazing, beyond words.
Our stay at Mammoth Hot Springs comes to an end, and the next morning when we want to leave, we meet this herd of elk right in the middle of town. The elks obviously prefer the lush green grasses to the dry environment and have learned to coexist with humans. Or is it the other way around? Which city can boast a picture like this in front of your visitor center?
Early next morning we're starting up our van, and our goal is by the end of the day to be back in Yellowstone Park again.
A beautiful overlook near Towers Roosevelt. Nice deep canyon with beautiful erosions, and a by chance discovery of an osprey nest when we followed the flight path of an adult bird that fed the young one. The young one is flapping its wings in preparation for the first flying lessons. We would have never spotted it if the adult didn't fly past us, but our location is even higher. I can't get a clear focus on it and move over to those beautiful basalt columns. We are being held up by some mountain goats. This is the lookout for Towers Waterfall. Up to another pass.
Mount Washburn, 2,700 meters high.
On the other side, we find the last highlight of our tour, the Grand Canyon of the Yellowstone. The river has carved out a very deep canyon, and the name comes from the predominant yellow color on the side walls. However, every other color is present too, and there should be even geysers, active geysers in the canyon. There are trails and lookouts on both sides of the canyon, and we want to visit all of them. The weather is not ideal, cold, cloudy and windy, but we are making the best out of it. As long as it's not raining or snowing, it's okay.
It's a real snake-like course the river has washed out. Some steam is rising here.
Inspiration Point is one of the many lookouts featuring especially nice views up and down the canyon.
Wow! A sliver of sunshine is breaking through. Hello! This is one of the most beautiful lookouts.
As we hike from one lookout to another one, we meet some wildlife, mule deer here. They are not shy at all, pretty well accustomed to the visitors. We are walking towards the trail to the lower falls, and I'm hoping to get some extraordinary pictures from there. The trail is pretty steep and strenuous. And so the story goes, just follow the way the river flows. The best pictures you will get where you spend a bit of sweat.
On the other side of the river, there's a long, steep stairway to lookout points. The steep, colorful side walls are very impressive, and we continue to work towards the upper falls. As planned, it is a day hike for us.
The weather is getting very nasty, it's windy and blowing. I try to get another shot of the falls and canyon, but it's starting to snow. Oh no, oh no. I have to stop taking pictures and go. So we're heading to the closest campsite, stopping over at the place called the mud pools. No more snowing here,
but a lot warmer.
What a beautiful color the grasses have. Just fantastic. It lets me get close enough to take some pictures. This is the view from our last campsite at Yellowstone Park, because tomorrow we are planning to leave. The first thing in the morning we see is buffaloes on the campground and also on the road when we leave. Today is a beautiful sunny day and we quickly change our plans and say let's head back to the Grand Canyon. So we come back to the same places we seen yesterday, but the sunlight is much better for photography and I'm hoping to get much better pictures than yesterday. Fortunately for us, the weather forecast was wrong and we're taking full advantage of it.
Yes, that's much better than yesterday.
And now we get a lesson of traffic controls by buffaloes. Mother knows best how to throw her weight around. For the last couple of minutes of this film, I want to give you a quick taste of the wildlife in Yellowstone Park. A moose with her young one. A black bear near our last campsite. Actually two, we caught a brown one leaning against a log. Then I shot some pictures of elks and the wolf family at the eastern side of the entrance. The last picture of a wolf cub has a special meaning for us. So much for this time. The end of the journey will come in the next film. Thanks for watching. Goodbye, au revoir und auf Wiedersehen.
Some free-roaming wolves in the park. Just like our Tasha. And the end is coming up soon. Thank you for watching.